A 2005 United Nations survey estimated that globally, 100 million people were homeless, with 1 billion living in inadequate housing. This number has likely increased significantly. New Zealand's homeless population is estimated to be one person in every 120. Over the past year, the number of homeless in Auckland has increased by 116%. The highest priority waiting lists for families needing accommodation had remained under 450 families for the last decade. As of last September, this number has dramatically increased to more than 2,800 families. Researchers found that overcrowding in New Zealand leads to at least 1,300 hospital admissions per year for severe infectious diseases. As a result, homeless people were found to spend on average 4 days longer per hospital visit, costing approximately $2,400 per hospitalisation. There are many theories that a single plastic bag can take up to 1,000 years to degrade. Only 3% of plastic bags are currently being recycled. Over 1 trillion plastic bags are produced every year. New Zealand alone contributes greatly to this issue, adding 40,000 plastic supermarket bags into landfills every hour. That's over a billion per year. Plastic bags never completely disappear. Over time, they just break down into smaller and smaller pieces of plastic. Plastic bags remain toxic even after they have broken down. Kiwis use 800 million bags each year, which works out to around 200 bags per head per year. Plastic makes up 7% of the New Zealand waste stream by weight, but by volume it is estimated that they may use up to 20% of landfill space.
In 2014, Palmerston North City Council stopped the collection of plastic bags in recycle bins and at recycling points. The recycling asset engineer stated that, unfortunately, there is no longer an economically viable market for the sale and recycling of plastic bags. In recent years, there has been a drive towards reducing the use of plastic bags at the point of sale. If plastic bags are no longer recycled locally, they will end up in landfills, or worse, in rivers and streams unless we find a creative use for them. Our approach to this task was essentially to take one societal problem, unrecycled plastic bags, and improve another societal problem, the living situation of homeless people. With winter approaching, we felt an ethical responsibility to provide homeless people with warm bedding. Through researching plastic bags in New Zealand, what they are used for, how they are disposed of, what happens to them after they are thrown away, it becomes clear that for a vast majority of consumers, plastic bags are a single-use, non-environmentally friendly product. The harm they cause to soil, rivers, oceans and wildlife is well documented. We took this waste product and repurposed it into a product that is beneficial for members of society and is not damaging to the environment.
The Homelit is a blanket created with recycled plastic bags and thread. We began with fusing the plastic bags into squares and then stuffed them with unmelted bags and stitched them together. The result is a large quilt-like blanket, roughly 72 centimetres wide and 180 centimetres long. Through extensive testing and trial and error, we have created a product that is durable and economically viable.
Although this marketing pitch is focused mainly on the homeless community, there are many other uses for the Homelit. Some possible uses are a hard-wearing insulator for camping, or a durable and waterproof picnic or concert blanket. The reasons we've discussed in this video are the primary motivations for why we think the Homelit should be a council-supported product. Not only is it economically sustainable, but it also addresses two major issues within our community: homelessness and plastic bag pollution. In creating the Homelit, we are tackling the requirements to improve not only New Zealand's communities, but also benefits communities globally. The Homelit aids disaster relief in third world countries, has practical and commercial use for activities such as camping, and creates positive solutions to the homeless and pollution problems in New Zealand. For these reasons, it is obvious that the council should give their full support in the creation and distribution of the Homelit.